We're still in the middle of winter here, but I think we've got a decent weapon of choice. This is the 2023 Mazda CX-30. It's got a turbo and all-wheel drive, and we haven't looked at it in a couple of years, so I think it's time to revisit this one. What's it like? Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Makse, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. The CX-30 has been with us for a couple of years. It's been a couple of years since we've looked at it on this channel. And this is kind of the right specification. It's got the big motor. It's all-wheel drive. And since this is the middle of winter here, it makes a lot of sense that we are driving this at the moment. But before we get into what it's like to drive, let's have a look at this in a little more depth. Mazda's crossovers and their cars actually follow a bit of a formula, and that's actually a good thing. What that means is you can put this 2.5-liter turbocharged four-cylinder in most of them, and here it makes 250 horsepower at 5,000 RPM and 320 pounds of torque at 2,500 RPM on 91 octane. If you are a cheapskate, you can run this on 87 octane. It makes a little less power and a little less torque. The transmission's a 6-speed automatic, which is actually beefed up for this turbocharged four-cylinder application. It is all-wheel drive, has a stronger rear diff mount and off-road traction assist. Suspension's based around McPherson struts at the front, torsion beam at the rear, and no, you internet trolls, there's nothing wrong with this torsion beam rear suspension, you just don't know what you're talking about. Suspension calibrations are retuned so that this does handle as nicely as the naturally aspirated model. Brakes are 295mm rotors at the front, 303mm rotors at the back, single piston calipers all around. Steering is electrically assisted. Of course. Wheels and tires are 18s, and I think that is the right choice here, and we'll get into that a little bit. Inside, this is absolutely stunning. Interior design is spot on. It's gorgeous. It's minimalist. It's exactly what I'm looking for. It's also very premium, and this one is fitted with the Bose sound system, and it does have adaptive front lights at this trim level as well, so very highly contented at this particular trim level. Curb weight of this thing is 3,500 pounds, and that is about 92 pounds heavier than the naturally aspirated model. The CX-30 is very much like a tall Mazda 3. So what you've got is basically the same layout inside, and that means you've got a very driver-centric cockpit, which is absolutely what I like. So you're seated a little higher off the floor, but a very comfortable, supportive seat, great interface to the steering wheel and to the pedals, and there is a dead pedal there if you do need it. The steering wheel is the right shape and the right size, lots of adjustment here as well, so pretty much anybody can fit perfectly behind the wheel. After that, it's very much Mazda ergonomics, so it is kind of minimalist in here, and it's just done so well. The climate control's easy to deal with. There's not a lot of wacky ergonomics going on here. It's very little, in fact. It's very easy to find your way into this Mazda CX-30 because everything is laid out so well. And then on top of that, this interior design is stunning. It's very clean, very straightforward, and everything is really oriented towards the driver. So instrument cluster, for example, very easy to read, and this one has a heads-up display, so you've got all the information you need when you're seated here as the driver. Because this is related to the Mazda 3 in size, like a tall Mazda 3, what that means is, in terms of spaciousness, you're fine here, you and your passenger. In that second row, though, there's not a lot of room. And in fact, I can barely fit behind myself in this seating position. There's really not a lot of room in that second row. Great for dogs and maybe small children who are out of their booster seats or child seats or whatever the case is. And thankfully, under the hatch, there's a decent amount of room. The seats do fold down if you need to throw your stuff in there. I certainly would use it that way. The infotainment system is Mazda's current system, and it uses this click dial wheel thing. And it's fine. It's not overly complex. It's very easy to live with, but I prefer to use it with Apple CarPlay because it just makes a lot more sense for me. But I think with a touchscreen, it's a little easier to live with an infotainment system like this. I'm kind of torn. I dig the fact that the screen is out there and the controls and the interface is relatively simple. I just don't like navigating through the screens with this click wheel. Thank you. I'm not quite sure what this does 0 to 60, but it seems like it's about 6.5 seconds. It's very quick. And then when you're on the move, because you've got this abundance of torque, this thing is real world quick. It makes peak torque in the middle of the rev range, so you've got instantaneous maximum torque anytime you need it. And because they've paired it with the 6-speed automatic, you're never hunting for gears either. It seems to be very happy in third and fourth gear as you're accelerating up to highway speeds. And again, that abundance of torque makes quick work of getting this thing up to highway speeds. Speaking of the transmission, that is one of the real highlights. The competitors tend to use CVTs, and this 6-speed automatic is just a breath of fresh air. It works like a traditional transmission should. You do have manual controls. Shifts are smooth both up and down the gearbox. It's just an excellent transmission, and the way that they've calibrated the transmission to work with the engine and the all-wheel drive system is perfection. Funny thing is, even though it's brutally cold and it is the middle of winter right now, we haven't had a lot of snow while I've been driving the CX-30, so I haven't been able to play with the all-wheel drive system. I'm very disappointed. The reason I'm disappointed is because I know they've spent a lot of time tuning this all-wheel drive system to work in all kinds of conditions. And in fact, it's got some off-road modes or off-road assist, which would be interesting. But I think when you do flip it to sport mode, it does send a little bit more torque to the rear axle, which would be much more fun in the snow, don't you think? I think this CX-30 has every single available option, which is a good thing. I like small cars with lots of features. This does have advanced driver assist and works great. Lane keep and adaptive cruise work just fine. I think, though, it is tuned on the safe side of things, and what that means is other drivers simply cut me off because they think I'm leaving that space for them to use. This is a very satisfying to drive compact crossover. And as I mentioned, steering is electrically assisted, but steering is excellent. They clearly have spent a lot of time calibrating this steering system to work very well. It's direct, precise, and there is a little bit of feedback that you get through the steering wheel, and it's just got the right amount of heft for an electrically assisted steering system. It works wonderfully, and that is reflected throughout the rest of this car's dynamics. For example, the brake pedal tuned perfectly. I have tremendous confidence on the brake pedal. Great feel, great control, and great modulation. They've done an excellent job with this brake pedal. And look at this, just braking perfectly. I've got millimeter control on that brake pedal, and then turn in response is excellent. And for me, where this CX-30 shines is in its suspension tuning. It's just wonderful. It does not really behave like a regular crossover, a benign kind of handling crossover. This is something you can drive into the corner on the brakes and then come out with an aggressive amount of throttle. And the reason is the suspension has been so carefully tuned. This thing handles so well. It handles head and shoulders above the competition. And in fact, I kind of hustled this through a couple of corners, and it's got a tremendous amount of grip, but also confidence. So if you do have this loaded into a corner, the suspension is working exactly the way it should. So not only can you have some fun in the corners, but you can really push this CX-30's limits and out-corner every other crossover out there. That's really where the CX-30 shines, and it is in its total dynamic package. The drivetrain is excellent, and then combined with the chassis tuning, it just does a wonderful job to satisfy you as a driver. Yeah, if you want a crossover like this, something a little taller, I understand. I might go with the Mazda 3 hatch, but that's just me. But for a crossover, this is incredibly fun to drive. And for you internet trolls, there is no problem with the torsion beam rear suspension. You have no idea what you're talking about. How do you spec yours? Well, as far as I'm concerned, there is only one way. At least mechanically, it should be like this with the Turbo 4 and all-wheel drive. Cosmetically, however, my tastes run to Soul Crystal Red paint. That metallic red is just gorgeous on every single Mazda they make, and that's what you should get. You can't get that red leather interior, but that is just fine. As far as pricing goes, as tested, this is about $36,000 US or $41,000 in Canada. Yes, it is on the smaller side, but it is very highly contented, which makes this a compelling choice in the crossover market. My verdict? Well, let's start with fuel consumption because it is important for a vehicle like this. What I find is that this is very efficient on the highway, not so much in the city, mostly because I like to use the throttle. I'm averaging about 25 miles per gallon or about 12 liters per 100 kilometers, but on the highway I'm doing much, much better than that. And if you do some long distance driving, you're going to be very happy with the efficiency of this CX-30. Now, that said, about the CX-30 Turbo, this is perhaps my favorite fun to drive crossover in this particular segment. In the compact crossover segment, this is hands down the best driving crossover. It's very much a Mazda. It's very satisfying to drive. And much of this is very much designed around the driver so that the driver can enjoy themselves. And absolutely, this is a blast to drive. And especially in this configuration with that motor, it's got plenty of power, plenty of torque. The 6-speed automatic does exactly what you want it to do, and it handles reasonably well. I like the quickness of it. I like the size of it. I love the fact that it is a compact crossover with lots and lots of content. If you are looking at something in this segment, you absolutely have to take a CX-30 Turbo for a drive. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 Mazda CX-30 Turbo all-wheel drive. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this episode with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. And we know Mazda still makes manuals. Anyway, thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Mazda CX-30 crossovers.